Hey, you guys, it's your girl, Dodge, coming back to you from Real Takes. Today, I'll be looking at a movie titled Can You Ever Forgive Me, starring Melissa McCarthy. And I'm going to tell you like this. I just could have sworn another trailer for another movie came out. I think it's called Life of the Party. That one was a busy bee. I do like Melissa McCarthy. I think she's hilarious. I watched Mike and Molly. She's a hoot. Of course, Bridesmaids. I loved her in Spy. And then she did a movie I liked, also a Tammy. So she stays busy. And she didn't seem to be slowing down anytime soon. I don't know anything about this movie. So with that said, you guys, let's just go ahead and just jump right into it.
Just these. I don't want the others.
Come on, man. I schlepped these all the way here.
There's people waiting.
You know, you don't have to be so disrespectful. You've actually carried my books here.
And you are?
Lee Israel.
Oh, we have copies of your latest work right over there.
Nobody is going to pay for the writer Lee Israel right now.
I'm months behind in my rent, and my cat is sick.
It's 4 p.m. Are you drunk?
I'm hardly drunk.
Craig, sober up.
My suggestion to you is you go out there and you find another way to make a living.
Recently found this delightful sign letter.
Fanny Bryce, one of my favorites. I could give you 75.
Oh.
I could give more for better content. It's a bit bland is all.
Yeah, I can definitely get a lot more for this one.
I mean, the P.S. makes it priceless.
Quite by accident, I find myself in a rather criminal position.
What criminal activity could possibly be involved in, except a crime of fashion force?
I'm embellishing literary letters by prominent writers.
I love his writing.
Particularly clever, don't you think? Caustic wit.
This is quite something. He's a wonderful.
I thought so, too.
Name your price.
You were looking at 1 month's rent.
What are you going to do?
Gamble,
shop, drink.
Ms. Israel, let me have a couple of questions regarding the last letter I purchased.
Uh-oh.
What seems to be the problem?
People are on alert. Your name's been put on a list.
On a list? They're literary treasures, one of a kind. It's my writing.
You're impersonating other people. Nobody's buying Lee Israel letters.
There have been some forgeries going around.
Do you think it's real?
Looks that way.
Good.
You're stealing from me?
Come on.
Get out of my house!
That's just supposed to be something more than this.
We're probably looking at some time behind bars.
What? I can't say that I regret any of my actions. In many ways, this has been the best time of my life.
Okay, you guys, I actually enjoyed that. I love to see Melissa doing another type of role that's not what from what we're always used to seeing, which seems to be more so on a comedy aspect as well. So I like that it's a drama. And I wonder when this is coming out. I didn't see when it says it's going to actually be released. I'm assuming probably late summer going into fall. And if that's the case, then it's a possibility it could get nominated. She's playing a very serious character. And I love that you get to see her, you know, pull those acting chops with that. Now, I like the whole premise of the actual story where she is, you know, an author, but she's not being touted because nobody's picking up her work. So she takes upon herself to do a form of deception using someone else's likeliness and, you know, people being, you know, enamored of the things or these findings she's, you know, using and making profit. And of course, it eventually catches up to her. And then to make it even worse, her friend turns on her and ends up using what she's done to, you know, make more money off her, even though they flagged her where her face is in certain, you know, location, book locations, and she can't even go in the building without being caught. But I love what she said at the ending. She was like, you know, I wouldn't take back what I've done because it's the best time I've had out of all of my life. The excitement, the sureness of, you know, the accolades of it all and people getting all excited about her, you know, bringing her stuff that she had nothing to do. Even though she, you know, edited it and did this, it's still not you. You're using someone else's name and likeness to, you know, you're foraging. So, you know, I can kind of go with this now. I don't know if I'm going to go out to see this, but I might consider it. Depending on when it drops. I just have to keep my eyes out on that. But I like this. Plus, I'm a fan of Richard E. Grant. Loved him for years. So I'm glad to see him in something recently. Nothing that's come across my eyes of him as of late. So this will probably be the first thing. I think Anna Deavere Smith's in this. I'm totally a fan of her work. She is awesome. So yeah, I'm going to keep my eyes watched out for when this actually is going to drop. And you know what? I just might go out and see this, you know. So with that said, comment guys below. Let me know what you guys think. If you all plan to see this or it's something you just worth waiting until it comes out on DVD. Understand that. I can appreciate that. And with that said, you guys, I'll see you on the next reaction. Take care.